Hello students, today we will be continuing with the lesson tissues part 3. In the first video we had learned about mesenteric tissues, in the second video we had learned about the simple permanent tissues, and today we are going to learn about the complex permanent tissues. Okay, just to revise, in the plant tissues are made up of mesenteric and permanent tissues. Mesenteric tissues divide throughout their life. They are present only in the specific areas of the plant body. So, they are made up of apical, lateral or intercalary meristems. Okay. Whereas, when these mesenteric tissues, they differentiate to form permanent tissues. Permanent tissues take up a specific job to do. If the job is simple in nature, it's simple permanent tissue, and the complex jobs in plants are done by xylem and phloem. So, it's complex tissues. Okay, in the previous video we learned about the simple permanent tissues, parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. In plants you have two complex tissues, xylem and phloem. Why are they called complex? Because they are made up of four groups, four members in each, xylem four members and phloem four members to do the complicated job. Okay, so let us go in detail. Okay, so permanent tissue is the simple permanent tissue, parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. These are doing simple jobs, so they are done alone by the people. Complicated jobs have to be done by group discussion or in a group. So, as seen here, so the complex permanent tissues are xylem and phloem. There are only two complicated jobs in plants, transportation of water and transportation of food. And xylem is made up of four elements, phloem is made up of four elements, and this group will help in the functioning of these complex functions in plants. Okay, so the two complex jobs in plants is transportation of water and transportation of food. In the plants, if you see children, there are tubes coming from the roots to the leaves. Throughout the stem and the leaves you can see two tubes. What are those tubes called as? They are the vascular bundles, that is the xylem and phloem. As we had learned in the previous video, you can inside the stem you have vascular bundles arranged. Okay, you have like this, and the vascular bundles are made up of xylem and phloem. In between you have the lateral meristem. Okay, so xylem is helping in the transportation of water, phloem helps in translocation of food. So let us go into detail. Complex permanent tissues, xylem and phloem. Okay, xylem, as I said, it is made up of four members. Remember the names: tracheids, vessels, parenchyma and fibers. All these four together help in conduction of water. Okay, phloem is made up of four members: sieve tubes, companion cells, parenchyma and fibers. All of them together are helping in the transportation of food. It's also called as translocation. Okay, and if you observe your children, in xylem most of the elements are dead. Only parenchyma is living. Clear? And among these four elements, it is the tracheids and vessels which are helping in conduction of water. Its parenchyma and fibers are just supporting it. Okay. Similar in phloem, in transportation of glucose, these four elements, out of these four elements, fibers are dead. The remaining three are living. Sieve tubes are living, companion cells are living, parenchyma are living cells. Only fibers are dead. And which element is helping in translocation? Sieve tubes. In xylem, it's tracheids and vessels helping in the transportation of water upwards. And in phloem, it's the sieve tubes and companion cells. Sorry, not companion cells. Sieve tubes are helping in translocation of food. Okay. So, just observe this picture here. We had already seen the structure of the stem. Okay? In the structure of the stem and the vascular bundles, how it is arranged. You can see the xylem and phloem, how it is arranged. And between the xylem and phloem, you have the strip of lateral meristem. Okay? If you enlarge it, you can see this. You can see this, children. This is a xylem. Okay? This is a cambium or the lateral meristem. And you have the phloem. This complete is one vascular bundle. If you observe the xylem, can you see any nucleus? These are the cells. You can see long cells. They are the tracheids and the vessels. They are long cells placed one above the other. Okay. The cells are placed one above the other and with the adjacent walls dissolved. And the walls are dissolved in such a way that it forms a continuous tube from the roots till the top of the plant. That is, the tracheids and vessels are made up of dead elements. They are dead cells, and it is through these dead cells the water will rise. It's like when you, there's a suction pressure, you keep your straw in your mouth and a suction pressure is created, the water comes up. So you will be learning about that in detail in 10th standard. So you now just have to remember, is the tracheids and vessels, the dead elements of xylem, helping in the transportation of water in the upward direction. Now look at the phloem here, children. It's not made up of dead elements, the sieve tubes. It is a living. Why it is called as a sieve tube? See, this is considered as one sieve tube. Here you will have a sieve plate, just like a filter. Can you see this here? Sieve plate. This is one sieve tube, this is one sieve tube. Between the two sieve tubes, you have a sieve plate. So they are living cells and they help in the transportation of food from the leaves to the other parts of the plant. So you will be wondering, what is the use of this companion cells, parenchyma, fibers, etc. You can see companion cells, you know, it is just giving company to the sieve tubes. Sieve tubes, you see, it is almost, it has to do a work of transportation of food. So you know how it has modified itself into, its all its cellular components have got decreased. It doesn't have a nucleus. Cytoplasm is so less. No mitochondria. Ribosomes are all it has lost. So, but it has to be alive and do its functioning. So the company's companion cells, which is giving its company, it provides all the materials for its survival, including ATP, proteins, etc. That's why it's called as a companion cells. Clear? Parenchyma is of course helping in the sideway transport or food storage, and fibers are for the support or the mechanical support. So I hope you understood the four elements of xylem: tracheids, vessels, parenchyma and fibers. Tracheids and vessels are dead elements, parenchyma is living, fibers are dead. In phloem, only fibers are dead, all the other three elements are living. So remember, the only element helping in transportation of water is tracheids and vessels, and in phloem it is the sieve tubes which is doing the functioning of translocation of food. Okay, so let us see what is a team xylem. Team xylem is responsible for transportation of water. So you can see the, how the water is transported. So what are the team xylem made up of? Vessels, fibers, tracheids and phloem and parenchyma. And you see the team xylem, how it is doing its work, how the water is moving up through the tubes, because it forms a continuous tube, no? And because of that continuous tube, the water can move without any obstruction, it moves up. Now let us see what is it team phloem doing. Team phloem is made up of sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. And you can see the glucose molecules, these are the glucose molecules along with water. This glucose molecules and water, it's a mixture of glucose molecules and water. It's coming from the leaves and it is moving to all parts of the plant. So you can see the difference in xylem, the movement is upwards. The water moves upwards. Whereas in phloem, the food is moving in all directions from the leaf. Is it clear? So here it is a living element helping in the transportation. Here is a dead element helping in. So you can see how efficient is a team xylem and team phloem, and how nicely they are carrying the work of complex jobs of transportation of food and water. Okay. Now, just if you in the exam, they may ask you the difference. You can see this here, children. This is a phloem tissue, very nicely shown, sieve tube. This is another sieve tube and this is a sieve plate. So you know the sieve plate, it is having holes so that the glucose and water can move from one cell to another. It can be pushed down from one cell to another. Okay. Now let us see the differences. First difference will be, xylem is made up of tracheids, vessels, parenchyma and fibers. Phloem made up of sieve tubes, companion cells, parenchyma and fibers. Second, what will you write? Xylem. In xylem, it is the tracheids and vessels are helping in the conduction of water. And in phloem, it is the sieve tubes which are helping in translocation of food. And in xylem, the parenchyma stores food and helping sideway conduction. In phloem, except phloem fibers, all are the living cells. Okay. You can also include the direction of the transportation in this difference between. In xylem, it is in vertically, as it's, of course, it's given here. Whereas in phloem, it is in all directions. That's a very important point you should write in the exam. Okay. Now, coming to the next part of the plant, epidermis. See, just like we have skin throughout our body, in the plants also, whether it is a leaf, stem or root, in every part of the plant, the outermost skin, its skin, it's called as the epidermis. Just like we have learned in the previous video, I've shown you that if you take a stem, this outermost part is epidermis. But outer to epidermis, there's one waxy coating called as a cuticle. That waxy coating cuticle, then you have the epidermis. And then inside the epidermis, you have the ground tissue. Then you have the endodermis. Under the endodermis, you have the pericycle. And then you have the vascular bundles arranged. This was the structure, okay, of the stem. And the root also almost similar. But in leaf, it is a bit different. But in leaf also, you have the epidermis upper and the lower epidermis. And you can see the vascular bundles in the leaf also. In stem also, you can see the epidermis. Then you have the vascular bundles. This is the root also. Clear? So in all the three, epidermis is common in all the three. Clear? So now let us know what are the characteristics you should learn about epidermis and what questions can come about it. It's the outermost layer throughout the entire plant. This now we discussed. Second point, no intercellular spaces and the outer and side walls are thicker. If you observe, here you had observed this epidermal layer here. Can you see any gap in between? No. If you can see this also, children. This look here on the board here. Okay. This is the epidermal layer here. I have just shown three cells of the epidermis. There is no gap between. And this is the outer wall of epidermis. And this is the side wall of epidermis. And this is the inner wall. It is facing towards the inside. Okay. So, the outer and the side walls are thicker, whereas the inner wall is thin. Clear? That's what the meaning of this. No intercellular spaces. The outer and the side walls are thicker. The outer and the side walls are thicker. The inner wall is thinner. And outer to the epidermis, you have a waxy coating that is called cuticle. Why is the cuticle necessary? Why the cuticle is necessary? 3 points, remember. It protects against loss of water, against mechanical injury and invasion of parasitic fungi. So what is the use of this waxy coating here? Because a waxy coating, it prevents the loss of water and it prevents mechanical injury and it also prevents the attack by parasitic fungi. Remember these 3 points. While the name cuticle is not given in your textbook, they have given only the word waxy layer. But that layer is actually called as cuticle, C-U-T-I-C-L-E. Okay. Now, next important point in the stem, root, leaf, the epidermis is there. But some speciality is there in each one of them. In case of stem, we told about the cuticle. Now, in case of leaf, this is the structure of the leaf, children. See, so beautiful, na? If you look into the structure of the leaf, this is the upper epidermis of the leaf. Okay. If you take a leaf like this, children, can you see the leaf clearly? This is the upper epidermis, okay, and this is the lower epidermis, and between the upper and the lower epidermis, it is like this. So many types of tissues are there, and in this lower epidermis, you know, there are lot of small pores called stomata. Clear? So here you can see this is the upper epidermis and this is the lower epidermis. And in the lower epidermis is a small stomata. So what is the speciality of the epidermis of the leaf? Stomata is present. What is the use of stomata? Transpiration and gaseous exchange. Clear? What's the speciality of the root epidermis? See, this is a section of the root. Okay? This is the epidermis. And the epidermal cells, you know, some of the epidermal cells will extend to form the root hair. Root hair is not a separate cell. It is extension of the epidermis of the root. So, epidermis of the root have hair-like parts. And why do you have root hair? To absorb water. To remember the speciality of the epidermis of the leaf, epidermis of the root. Next one, epidermis of the leaf. See, so cute, na? This is the epidermis. This is the structure of the leaf. Upper epidermis. This is a lower epidermis. And in upper epidermis, this yellow color, it's the cuticle, the waxy coating. If you take a plant like this, you see this, can you see? Okay, what happens here when you put water, it's not getting wet. Why it doesn't get wet? Because of the presence of waxy coating called cuticle. You know, in villages, children use a colocasia plant as an umbrella. It doesn't get wet. It's a big leaf, no? So, they just use that as an umbrella because the water will not enter into the cells here. Okay, it's just like when you apply Vaseline or cream in your hand and you wash your hand, hand doesn't get wet. Okay, now xerophytes are the desert plants. They have a very thick cuticle above the epidermis. This is the epidermal layer, and the cuticle is so thick. So you have modified the word and made it as cutin. So the thick cuticle in xerophytes is called as cutin. Okay. Now, again coming back to this structure. Okay, children, can you see? We had already learned. Again, you have the cuticle, you have the epidermis, and then after the epidermis, hypodermis. After hypodermis, you have the ground tissue, and then you have endodermis. Endodermis, remember? And then you have the vascular bundles. Just for revising, I have told you. But now, see, when the stem is so tender like this, no, the structure is the same. This is a structure in a tender stem. But when this shoot or the young shoot, it grows, it starts growing into a tree. Do you feel it can survive with this green stem and it grows up? No, no, it will fall down. It cannot hold a such big banyan tree or a big huge tree with such a soft shoot, which broken so easily. It cannot. So it needs to have some extra cells for mechanical support. So as the tree grows up, no, when it becomes bigger, this epidermal layer, you know, it will get replaced. Uske upar ek naya layer aa jayega. There's a new layer formed over the epidermis. Okay. And that layer is called as, it's a secondary meristem. That's a new type of tissue which is called as a secondary meristem. Primary meristem, we have already learned apical, lateral and intercalary meristem. This is called as the secondary meristem because it is coming in the secondary stage of its life cycle. And when this meristem appears, replacing the epidermis, from here lot of new cells will start coming. So many new cells will start coming, it forms a thick bark. Okay, and the bark also is fully made up of dead cells, and it will have a special chemical called suberin. And because of that, even if water, so much of, if it is exposed to so much of rain and all, the water doesn't enter into it because that chemical prevents the entry of water. Clear? So just read it. As the plants grow old, epidermis gets replaced by secondary meristem. The cells outside the secondary meristem form the bark or the cork. So the epidermis, the secondary meristem will divide so fast and thick layer of bark will be formed. Okay, and that bark has a special chemical. What is the name of that? Suberin. And what is the property or the quality of the suberin? It is impervious to gases and water. It will not allow any water or gases to move into the part. So the outer part of the tree is made up of dead cells, but inner part is made up of living cells. Okay. Have you seen this, children? Can you identify? Okay. This is a bark of the oak tree. It's all having economic importance. You know why? The bark of the oak tree is used for making the cork. In the laboratory, use a cork, no? Two hold and one hold cork and all. It's actually, this cork is made up of the bark of the oak tree. You can see this, see how it was, the thick bark was formed after the secondary meristem was formed. And this person is removing it. Within 5-6 years, you know, again the bark will be formed. So there is no harm in removing it. It's only a dead cell. Similarly, this one, you know, this is cinnamon. Cinnamon which you use as a spice in your, mummy uses in kitchens now. So that, this is cinnamon. It's also a bark which is of high economic importance. Okay. It can be removed and it is actually a result of secondary meristem. Fine. Now let us see whether you remember whatever I have taught you today. Okay. Name the xylem and the phloem elements. Which among them are living? Okay. Xylem elements. Tracheids, vessels, parenchyma, fibers. And which are the phloem elements? Sieve tubes, companion cells, parenchyma and fibers. Second part of the question. Which among them are living? Here, only the parenchyma is living. All the three are dead. Here, all these three are living, fibers are dead. Okay. Second question. Name the xylem elements which transport water and minerals. Which, there are four members, but which is really involved in that? It is tracheids and vessels. Tracheids and vessels are formed like this, long hollow structures. You know, it also has holes here, pits. The water can even flow out of these two sides. Okay, so tracheids and vessels. Next one, name the phloem elements which are involved in translocation of food. Which are they? It's only the seed tubes. What is the function of companion cells? I had explained to you. It's only giving company to the seed tubes. Next one, identify the location of the following chemicals on the plant body. This is one of the questions usually asked for the exam. Give the location of the following chemicals: pectin, suberin, and cutin. Do you remember where is pectin found? Pectin is found in collenchyma, suberin is found in the cork or the bark, and the cutin is present in the epidermis of the desert plants. Okay. Now, this is the anatomy of the leaf. We had already learned, if you recall the structures. Okay, now for the question of that. Identify part X. Give three functions of this part. Can you identify this part? It is cuticle. And what is its function? It protects against the loss of water, mechanical injury, and invasion of parasitic fungi. Second question. Identify part Y. This is part Y. What is the speciality of their walls? Okay, what's the answer? This is epidermis, upper epidermis. And what is the speciality of the walls? You remember I had drawn here and shown you. The outer and the side walls. This is the outer and the side walls are thicker. And the inner walls are thinner. Okay? Third one. What is the speciality of the part Z? Lower epidermis in leaf. What is it having? It has stomata. And what is the function of stomata? Exchange of gases and transpiration. Okay? That's all, children. Stay focused and keep revising. Thank you.